what we just got through talking about. Amen. That's what I was saying, man. That's why a person has to, you got to read these Proverbs every day. It's wisdom. Wisdom. Like I was saying earlier, you know, because I read it in the morning before I get up. And something happened in that day that is going to take you back to that proverb. One of the, it never fails. It never fails. It never fails. That's why it's 31 Proverbs for every day. Get up and read it before you go out there into that world. Because you don't know what's out there waiting. You know, get that wisdom before you leave out that door in the morning. It says, verse 12, it is abomination. Oh, we just read that, didn't we? 13, righteous lips are the delight of kings, and they love him that speak it right. Amen. That's self-explanatory. Verse 14, the wrath of a king is like a messenger of death, but a wise man will appease it. The wrath of a king is like the measure of death. It's like the message of death, but a wise man will appease it. King James says, in the light of a king's countenance is life, and his favor is as a cloud of the latter rain. Amen. You know what that latter rain is, don't you? Man. Verse 16. How much better is it to get wisdom than gold? And to get understanding rather to be chosen than silver. You can have all the money in the world. If you ain't got no wisdom, you ain't gonna keep it. And if you ain't got no wisdom, you ain't gonna even know how to even get it. Not the right way. Not the right way. Because quickly you get it, deceivably or dishonestly, and quickly it'll fly away. I know that firsthand. Amen. Verse 17. Want to read? Highway of the upright is to depart from evil. He that keepeth his way preserve his soul. Amen. Got to love. You got to treat people right. When you do right, when you sow love, when you sow peace, when you sow joy, you receive, you reap all that. You reap all that. When you sow wickedness, when you sow deceit, when you sow hate, you reap it all. All. That's why, you know, it'd be surprised. It's real surprising that the prison steady grow and grow and grow. When you know that what you sow, now you reaping. But people so cold-hearted that they don't even care about what's going on with in their lives, knowing that they put themselves in prison by being deceitful, hateful, manipulative, and the consequences put them where they was at, where they at, and they don't want to going to change that. And they keep doing the same thing over and over. I just don't understand that. And I'm saying it's revolving. And there'd be some people that's coming in and out of prison 3, 4, 5 times. And I'm like, wow, why in the world? You haven't learned it. And I'm talking about some of these people staying there 10, 15 years and then get out and do the same thing. And I'm just like, how? Why? You know, you need to be doing something different. You got to. I don't understand it. Yes, I never will, because you can see yourself physically. You can see what your actions cause you. And you still want to stay in that miry clay and just stay there and just keep wallowing in the mud like a pig going back to the slop. And it's sad. It really is. It's real sad. But you do have some that learn. It only takes one time. It only takes one time. Verse 18, it says, an amplified, pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. There's that pride again. Verse 9, huh? Everybody has a story, and yours is no greater than the next person, you know. So that's yes, yeah. Mm-hmm. The old people say, pastor and people older than pastor, it only takes a second to get in trouble, but it takes a lifetime to get out of it. And that's so true. It's so true. All it takes is a second. That's it. It changed the whole course of your life. So everybody has a story. That's why we're supposed to pray for those who, that's those who's doesn't have or the type of state they might be in mentally, spiritually. That's why we got to pray for them, intercede, because like you said, it could be us. And once upon a time, it probably was us, and those that were around us prayed, encouraged us. And we need to, freely it's been given, freely you give. Amen. It says 20, he who pays attention to the word of God will find good. This is amplified. And blessed, happy, prosperous, to be admired is he who trusts confidently in the Lord. He who pays attention to the word of God, lamp unto our feet, light unto our path. Amen. 21. It says, amplified, the wise in heart will be called understanding. A sweet speech increases persuasively in learning in both speaker and listener. You speak that word of wisdom that God has given us. It's not only for us, for those, it's for us also, for the speaker and the listener. Verse 22, anybody? That's why we all... Amen. That's why we come to, another reason why we come together. Counsel of the wise. We can. That's why we come together. In service, because we have some wise counselors. Because if you wasn't wise, you wouldn't be serving the Lord. You wouldn't be in the house of the Lord. You got some wisdom, or you wouldn't even be here. It's been passed down. You listening, you know. All right. It said that 23, the heart of the wise instructs his mouth in wisdom and adds persuasiveness to his lips. Yeah. When it says, and the heart of the wise teaches his mouth and added learning to his lip, in King James. The heart of the wise teaches his mouth, and added learning to his lips. Amen. 24, pleasant words are as an honeycomb, sweet to the soul and health to the bones. Life and death is in the power of the tongue, and those who love would eat the fruit thereof. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. We all can speak about that scripture right there. We thought we was doing something right, and all the time we was doing something wrong. But God's grace and his mercy didn't allow us to die in our sins. Amen. He that labored for himself, for his mouth craved it of him. Verse 27. An ungodly man diggeth up evil, and his lips there is as a burning fire. You have one that he's always want to bring up what they did or what he did or what she did. You know, always trying to keep something stirred up. You know, a busybody, a gossiper. And God said he hate those who sows discord amongst the brethren. So a person better be careful about putting their mouth on God's anointing, stirring up stuff in the body. Because, he says that in Proverbs, he hates those who sow discord among the brother. Amen. Verse 28. A perverse man spreads strife, and one who gossips separates intimate friends. That goes along with what we just got to be talking about in 27. Verse 29. A violent and exceedingly covetous man entice his neighbor to sin. And leads him in a way that is not good. Excuse me, I didn't finish reading it. A violent and exceeding covetous man entices his neighbor to sin and leads him in a way that is not good. God has placed people in our path. Which way are we going to go? Are we going to lead them the right way, or are we going to lead them the wrong way? That there is it. I had people come up to me and says that they was in a game because of me, and I'm talking about these people that they know I might have hung around their brother or their sister or even people in my own family that said that, and that was real disheartening to me, that they would tell, that they, you know, that and that drives me even more now to live right, because the legacy that I want to leave, if I have to leave one, is that he loved Jesus. And most of all, though, that he was obedient to him. That's what I want to leave. I don't that old man that was gone, dead, stinking in the grave, that's not what I want to people to remember me by. That he loved Jesus and he's obedient to Jesus, that's what I want to leave, you know. And that hurt my heart when my little cousin, you know, come up there and said that to me. And he's been in and out of trouble since he was a kid. He did so much stuff, they done kicked him out of Midwest City. He's supposed to get out this year, and he can't come back to Midwest City. That's just... So, okay, verse 30. It said, he shutteth his eyes to devise forward things. Moving his lips, he bringeth evil to pass. Yes, we got to speak up for those. We got to take up for those who can't look out for themselves, who can't speak up for themselves. We need to be doing that. I was talking to a brother at work today, and we're just talking about, you know, politics and the world and what's going on in the world today. And I was telling him, he's a believer, and I said that we as Christians have dropped the ball on that, praying and being what God called us to be in this world. I say, especially in the United States, when we say that, you know, this is, you know, we're a Christian nation. And our prayers, we're not praying like we, and this has been going on for a while, that, you know, we ain't been praying like we're supposed to. We've been shutting our eyes, closing our ears to things that's going on in the world. And that's why the nation is in so disarray, so in so much trouble as it is now, because we didn't do our part. Ain't no way in the world that, you know, we're supposed to be not saying anything when they talk about the same-sex marriages and abortions and all this stuff that's, you know, going against God's laws. And so I was telling them, man, we're in a lot of trouble in America. We really are. Here we is, land flowing with milk and honey. We have been blessed, truly been blessed, and we don't even appreciate it. We don't appreciate it. And the time is coming. The time is coming. The verse 31, the silver-haired head is a crown of splendor and glory. It is found in the way of righteousness. Pastor, you sure enough can speak to that. if it is found in the way of righteousness, yeah. Yes. Amen. I see some gray over there. Yeah, you ain't. Yeah. We're gonna let you have some fun too. Yeah. You gonna have some fun too. We ain't gonna have all the fun by ourselves. You right along with us. Yeah. Yeah, it's a blessing. And I mean, ever since I started walking, living for Jesus, it started sprouting out even more. Yeah. Yeah. I ain't like Moses over there, but, you know. Amen. He who is slow to anger is better and more honorable than the mighty soldier. And he who rules and controls his own spirit than he who captured a city. What spirit do you have? You know, when you don't have the Holy Spirit, you have all type of spirits in you. Different types of all types. How many different spirits I used to have in me, you know, that it caused me to do some of the evilest things that it would even have. Here it is, another person that used to love to shoot and love to do things that was devious looked at me in one day and said, "Man, what are you doing?" Yeah. For him to say that to me, there was a lot of wicked spirits in me. Yeah. And he lived by the sword, which I mean he lived by the gun. And he asked me that. That was my best friend. So.